बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस डबल इंटीग्रल फॉर नॉन रेक्टेंगुलर रीजन फॉर टू टाइप्स ऑफ रीजन। फर्स्ट टाइप ऑफ रीजन इज दैट इफ रीजन इज बाउंडेड द लेफ्ट एंड राइट बाय वर्टिकल लाइंस x इज इक्वल टू ए एंड x इज इक्वल टू बी। लेफ्ट वर्टिकल लाइन इज एट x इज इक्वल टू ए एंड राइट वर्टिकल लाइन इज एट x इज इक्वल टू बी and its values about y-axis below and above by curves y is equal to g1x and y is equal to g2x means our values about x-axis are a points a number a and b but along y-axis there are curves means by different values of x there will be different values of y in such a way that at point A if A is less than B then g1x is less than or equal to g2x in such a way integral will be of type double integral of the region can be written as dA into dA dA means dx dy or dy dx. Now this dA is equal to dx dy or it could be dy dx. Now as values of y are depend upon value of x, these are curves, g1x g2x are curves, so this integral will be written as f of x y, y are curves so these will be dy and x are numbers so it will be written as dx. Now for dy limits are g1x and g2x, for x limits are a to b. The graph for such function can be drawn as if we are drawing the graph between x and y in two dimensional system, rectangular coordinate system. If this is x is equal to a and this is x is equal to b, now curves are bounded above and bounded below, means value of x are this a and b. Curves for y, this is bounded above curve and here is bounded below curve, means this curve represent g1x and this is for g2x. Then area bounded by this region will be this, that will be find out by using double integral form. Now we will discuss type 2 region. Type 2 region is defined as, in type 2 region horizontal lines are number y is equal to c and y is equal to d but bounded on left and right is continuous curve. Left is continuous curve h1y and right is continuous curve h2y. In this type of region y are numbers but x represent curves such that at x is equal to c curve, at y is equal to c curve along x is h1y and at y is equal to d curve of x is h2y. Now we are here to draw graph for such curve, then in such a way double integral formula f of xy dA can be written as here are x are in curve form, so this will be written as f of x y into dx dy. X is curve, so its limit are h1x to h2x, and y are some fixed number, so its limit are from c to d. Graph for such function can be defined as, if we are going to draw a graph in coordinate system for x and y, if this is x axis, y axis, value is y from c to d, this is c and d, and x are some curves, and these curves are represented as then this region bounded by curves and numbers, we have to find its area by using double integral. This is first curve for x is equal to h1x, and this is second curve for x is equal to h1y and x is equal to h2y. Mean value of x depends upon value of y. So graph will be of such type. Now if a sketch of a function is given, then how we can write double integral for the given function of f of x into y. As from this given sketch, it is clear that values of y varies from 1 to log of it, and values of, if this value is not given, this point is given. From here we can see that this is value of x along x coordinate and this is along y coordinate. So drawing perpendicularly from this, we can see that this is point log of it. So here it is clear that x value starts from 0 and end at log of it. So we can see that double integral for such function f of xy can be written as function, this is the graph of function x is equal to log of y. So we can say that graph of function is for x 0 to log of y, means x values are of curve type, that is log of y depends upon value of x. So y integral will be outside and x integral will be inside, and this is f of xy. Now x is from 0 and second is its log of y curve. So when we will put here values, we will see that value of y is from 1 to log of it. So y is from 1 to log of it. Now its integral can also be written as, if we are written this double integral with function dy dx, such that we will write dy inside if y upper and lower limits are of the curve type. Now from here we can see that value of x, if we take value of x constant, means we can write it as 0 to log of it outside 0 to log of it and take y as a curve. So from here y curve is start from point 1. This is a hyperbolic curve. So in this curve this is starting from 1, not starting from 0. This is an exponential curve. This is the graph of an exponential function, simple exponential function. So we can say that its lower is e of x and upper value is log of 8. Because when we will put x is equal to 0, e power 0 is 1, means our graph starts from at y is equal to 1. So these are two types of the region. First region is when we are taking y as a x as a curve and y constant, and second is when we are taking y as a curve and x as a constant. So these are two types of region that can be defined from the given sketch graph. So either you write it as it is or in this form, in both cases integral will give us a same answer. There will be no change in the answer. Order of integration not affects the answer that we have to obtain from the integral. Now we solve it, that how we can say that these two integrals are equal. Firstly, take this integral and prove that this integral is equal to the second integral. As first integral is given as 1 to log of 8, 0 to log of y, f of xy, dx dy. Now, limits of x are from 1 to log of 8. So here we can say that x lies between 1 and log of 8. Limits of y are from 0 to log of y. So here we can write 0 to log of y. Now we have to take log on each side of this second equation. Now take log on each side of equation 2. When we will take log here, we can get that log of 0 less than or equal to log of y less than or equal to log of, this is log of y values, y values are from 1 to log of 8 and x values are from 0 to log of y. We have made correction here and take log on each side of equation 1. We will get here log of 1 less than or equal to log of y log of 8. As we know, log of 1 is equal to 0. So 0 less than or equal to log of y and less than or equal to log of 8. Now from equation 2 and equation 3, it is clear that this is equation 2, this is equation 0 less than x less than log of y. This log of y is further less greater from 0 but less from log of it. So we can say that x limit is also lies between 0 and log of it. That is from second integral. This implies that x lies between 0 and log of it. And log of y lies between x and log of it. First is this by using 0 and log of it, and second for y is for x and log of it. Now taking anti log, this will become e power x less than or equal to y, because log and anti log cancel each other. Here log and anti log also cancel each other and we will get log of it. So y limits are from e of x to log of it. For this x and y condition, we can write, now y is in term of curve function type, so we can take y inside and x outside. Limits of y are e of x to log of it, and x limits are from 0 to log of it. So from here we can see that either we write given sketch for into double integral form like first or second, both have same answer and same meaning. Both are interchangeable to each other. In this question we have to draw sketch of given region for this integral and evaluate equivalent integral with order of integration reversed. We have to reverse order of integration because in this given double integral y is of curve type and x is constant. Now we have to make an other double integral for this function such that x will be of curve type and y will be with the constant value. Now from this given double integral, it is clear that y is equal to x square and y is equal to 2x. We have two functions, y is equal to x square and y is equal to 2x. So we have to take different values of x from 0 to 2 and put in function 1 and function 2 respectively. When we will put x is equal to 0 and very different values up to x is equal to 2, we will see that value of function y for x is equal to 0 will be 0, for x is equal to 1 will be 1, for x is equal to 2 will be 4. Means this will give us a curve of this order of square of each value of x. Now for y is equal to 2x, when we will put x is equal to 0, we will get y is equal to 0. For x is equal to 1, y will be 2. For x is equal to 2, y will be 4. So from here we will get this graph. This curve line is for y is equal to x square. This straight line is for y is equal to 2x. This is the point at which x is 2, y is 4. So this point is 2 and 4. and this is the region whose area we have to calculate. Now we will draw an alternate sketch where x will be in curve form and y will be with the constant. Now as we know y is equal to x square, taking square root on both sides we will get x is equal to square root of y, and for second we will get x is equal to y by 2. Means we have variation for x from square root y and y by 2. Now along x-axis and y-axis limits will remain same, 0 to 2 and 0 to 4. And we will see that when we will sketch graph for x is equal to square root of y, this graph will be for y is equal to 0, x is 0. For x is y is equal to 1, x is equal to 1. For y is equal to 2, x is equal to square root 2. For y is equal to 3, x is equal to square root of 3. And for x, y is equal to 4, value of x will be 2. Means for different value of y, we will sketch a graph, and this graph will be of this type. Now for second curve, we will put for y is equal to 0, x value will be 0. For y is equal to 1, x value will be 1 by 2. For y is equal to 2, value of x will be 1. And so we will get a graph for two different curves. This first curve represent x is equal to square root of y, and this second curve, that is straight line, shows that x is equal to y by 2, and we have to calculate area of region bounded by this. Now we can say that we had derived two type of integrals, given that is y lies between x squared to 2x and x limits are from 0 to 2. Limits of y, these are limits of y. These are limits of x. Now multiply equation 2 this is equation 1 this is equation 2 now multiply 2 by 2 we will get 0 less than equal to 2x less than or equal to 4. Now compare to 1 and 3. We will get x square y is greater than x square but less than or equal to 2x, and this 2x is further less than or equal to 4. So from here we can say that x square less than y and this is x square, from x is further less than 2, 0. So here we can say that this x square is further less than 0. So from here we can see that जीरो वाई लाइज बिटवीन जीरो एंड फोर एंड दिस फंक्शन वी कैन से दैट y is less than or greater than or equal to x square, y is less than or equal to 2x. From here we can see that x less than or equal to square root y and x less than or greater than or equal to y by 2. Now combining these two we will get that x is less than square root y but greater than y by 2. So this is x limitation. We can write it as x as a curve form. So our function will become 4x plus 2 dx dy, where x limits are from y by 2 to square root of y and y limits are from 0 to 4. So sketch also shows that this is same, and by reversing order we have also shows that this is double integral is equivalent to the given double integral. Now we can also prove that by solving this new introduced double integral and given double integral, we can see that answer of both integral will be same. So we can say that reverse of order of integration doesn't affect the solution of the integral. In this step, we have taken x square less than greater than or equal to 0 because from equation 2 it is clear that x is greater than or equal to 0. If x is greater than or equal to 0, then its square is also greater than or equal to 0. And that's all about today's lecture.